Jesus said to his disciples, I have much more to tell you, but you cannot bear it now. But when he comes, the Spirit of truth, he will guide you to all truth. He will not speak on his own, but he will speak what he hears, and will declare to you the things that are coming. He will glorify me, because he will take from what is mine and declare it to you. Everything that the Father has is mine. For this reason I told you that he will take from what is mine and declare it to you. Brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please always be here.
Good morning. Right after the entrance song during a Sunday Mass, a man covered from head to toe in black with a machine gun entered the church. And he shouted, anyone willing to take a bullet for Christ, stay where you are. And immediately the people fled to all possible exit doors. And out of 500, at the start of the Mass, only 50 remained. Then the man in black, sitting in his hood, looked at the parish priest and said, Holy Father, I just got rid of your church of all plastered Christians. Now you can continue your worship. Have a good day. It's an anecdote that you must have heard more than once. It's not a true story, but the true story is this, that in one Sunday worship, a son of the Bosco, a student in an Islamic country, approached a suicide bomber, embraced him until the bomb exploded and he died in the bomb. He did not only stand for Christ, he protected his church. Meron pong version niya sa Tagalog. Minsan ako, isang mama tumakil sa parish priest, sabi, Father, can I make my confession? Halika na, doon tayo sa sudo. Pagkatapos ng blessing, Father, for I have sinned. Father, I killed 20 people. Nakapatay ko ako ng 20 na tao. Gulat-gulat ko, Father, ha? Bakit na? Masama ang tumunan. Bakit ko silang tinay? Kasi yung Father, naniniwala sila sa Diyos. Kayo po ba, Father? Naniniwala rin ba kayo sa Diyos? Ano sa Diyos, Father? Dati. Ngayon, trik-trik lang. Hindi po trik-trik, ha? Hindi dinigay, hindi tira-tira ang bigay kay Kristo. To love Jesus means to swear, I will give my life for you. Even if I have 1,000 lives, as Saint Lorenzo Ruiz would say. Today is the feast of Our Lady of Fatima, and the story of Mary is the story of God giving his best to a human creature, kaire, kekarine, hail, full of caris, full of gifts, full of charism, caris, full of charity, full of love. Hail Mary, fully gifted, fully loved. But the story of Mary is also the story of a human creature giving his very best to God. And that includes being persecuted and being even martyred for her faith. Because you know very well at the time, by accepting to conceive a son because of some unknown godly intervention, Mary accepted to be stoned to death by her family. I swear I'll give my life for you. Ano po sabi niya ng mga malinis? No name? No name. Sabi niya, Air Force, no gods? No glory. Sabi ng army, no degree? No surrender. Sabi ng mga security guards? No ID? Pero pansin po ninyo, ang no ID, no entry ay walang Tagalog translation. Kasi matutuwa ko mga estudyante, no? Walang ID, walang paso. This is our identification card as followers of Jesus, our full entry into Christian discipleship, and that is to stand for Him, especially in the worst of times, in times of mockery and intolerance because of our Christian upbringing, in times of prejudice, stereotyping, and hatred for the church because of the scandals of the clergy, in times of full indifference toward Christians being persecuted in some fundamentalist society. Are you ready for that? What Jesus is saying in our gospel today, Mary already believed during the Annunciation. I have much more to tell you, but you cannot bear Him now. But when He comes, the Spirit of truth will guide you to all truth. Nangyayari po yan sa buhay natin, no? Na hindi natin lubusan na naiintindihan. Only much, much later, you will realize, wow, it all makes sense now. But even despite the lack of understanding, Mary said, be it done unto me according to your word, at the cost of our very life. The theme of our JP2 conference is rekindling catechesis. And to me, I believe, today, we can rekindle catechesis if we can tell the stories of our present-day martyrs. Tell the stories of our present-day martyrs. Those persecuted for the faith. Bakit ko? Kasi noon, sabi na nakakatanda, ang edukasyon, ang pinto para sa tagumpay. Noon po yun. Ngayon, sabi ng mga estudyante, ang edukasyon, ang pinto para sa tagumpay at ang pangungopya ay ang susi. Kaya yung exams, tumitigala sila for inspiration, yumuyuko for concentration, at tumitigin sa paligid for more information. Kaligtad na po ang mundo. But more seriously, we are living in a world where we love things and use people instead of the other way around. Where we value animal rights more than human life. Where it is